Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
And welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim Special Edition. It's been a number of weeks now. You can see that Sundar has changed his appearance. He's got a Redguard outfit on now with a bear cloak. And he's also got a lantern attached to his waist. That's another mod, wearable lanterns. And he has chosen to ignore the summons of the Greybeards and strike out on his own and develop his powers that have been given to him by Tall Papa. So we are now level 15. And we are out here. Let me just show you on the map. Out here at Nightgate Inn, and we spent the night here, and we are traveling, actually I guess over here, we're going to Windhelm, and Sundar has chosen to just discover the lay of the land and develop his abilities the best he can, and help people here and there as they need it. All right, so we're going to strike out again. I'm not sure what quest we have chosen here. Oh, okay. Yeah, we've done a lot of dungeon exploring too, and one of the things that was found was Meridia's beacon. So we have that, and I'm going to just turn that off for now because I do want to go to Windhelm. Yeah, I can definitely see why. Oh, and I guess the other thing is that, uh-oh. Whoa, I can't control the horse now. The other thing is that Sundar now has a horse. So he purchased that at the Whiterun Stables, and that cat really, took something out of him here. His health was, taken down. Bronze Water Cave discovered. Alright, well, since we've been dungeon diving, we're just going to continue to do that on our way to Windhelm. So I've made some adjustments. Hopefully the brightness and the sound. Oh, shit. What the hell? So as you can see, Sundar is working on his conjuration. He's now able to conjure a bound sword. Some dual wielding action. And I'm not sure what this is that keeps coming up. Your wild companion has found its way back to you. I was messing around with some spells and I don't know what I did. But now that thing just keeps popping up in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. So hopefully one day I'll figure out how to turn that off. So is this it? Alright, well I guess some caves are just... Oh, there is a chest here. I'm not sure what you do with this Dwemer scrap. I'm going to take it since my carry weight is extremely high thanks to the earring of Unburden that I'm wearing. All right, we will just continue on then. So I can definitely tell the difference with this Better Horses mod. The horse moves a lot faster, and I think that's really what was messing up my the opening sequence of the game. Horse was moving too fast for the cart that it was carrying. Oh. Wow, this horse just starts running on its own. Is definitely not very smart. Just gonna stand there and let the thing attack it. Okay. Well, since we're here, we'll go ahead and go in this cave. What's this here? It's empty. Forsaken cave. I hear wolves in here. And now that he's discovered he's Dragonborn and has unrelenting force, Shout certainly knows how to use it to his advantage in a fight. This don't look good. Was easy enough. Oh, wait, is this a chest? Yes. Still an enemy around here somewhere. these enchanted talismans and stuff are fantastic. I can just keep using the powers over and over. Yeah, I know I'm cheating, folks, but I'm having fun. Having fun doing it. Right, they're both empty. Oh. Sorry, I didn't see you standing there. Oh, block increased and leveled up. Let's see, do I really need these iron ingots? I guess I'm taking them though, huh? I have all these empty urns here. I hear breathing. Oh, shit! Jeez. Starting to get lost now. Alright, I think we came... Yeah, definitely came down that way. I see corpses. Okay, there was a door. Yes, here it is. So I guess that's, I don't really know much about these, dungeons, I guess you might call these. But I guess you just go in here, fight off some enemies, and collect a chest. It seems the pattern that I'm seeing here. I mean, sometimes I think these are a little bit more involved, but other times it's just this. Just in case. Oh, we always in the market for some gold. Now, I don't know if embalming tools are important in this game. It's like, do I need to pick these up? I don't know. I know you need a pickaxe so that you can mine ore and stuff, but I'm gonna just leave the... Oh. Well, he's standing in the fire. Shit. Oh shit, I'm on fire now. I'm trying to see if there's anything in these urns. Oh, shit. Oh! I saw that at the last second I stepped on that plate. Oh, now we got some silver. Definitely time for a save here. Forsaken Crypt. Alright, we're going to go back to using our shield. Looks like we can keep moving. Ancient Nordic sword in bad condition? It looks nice. Okay. I like the way these swords look. Again, this is another mod where they were retextured. Okay, there's a way out over there. Let's see what we got over here. Some ingots. Healing potion. Now, okay, I think we were down here, I believe. I don't remember seeing this up here, but anyhow, it looks like this is the way to go. I think I've also got a mod that gives me, I guess, increased or different racial abilities. I think when he bursts into flames, that's part of the Redguard ability. Could be wrong, but I've been seeing people bursting into flames. Whoa! Ooh, almost died. Damn, look at that! Okay. All right, and there was a door over here too. It's like I just out of instinct just want to go and run over that plate to get to this door here. Hold on. Alright, this looks pretty enclosed. You know, I'm starting to think I might need to increase the difficulty since my character is so powerful. I heard a sword. Somebody's up here. Huh. I'm just looking at the value of these things, and it's always, you can never have too much gold. Uh-oh. All right, who's there? Yeah, what you gonna do? who's next? Oh no, I see a word up there. Kuramil, what you got on you? Irresistible frost damage. Too bad you really didn't get a chance to use it. Oh. And a chest. What is this? How much closer do I need to get? Kill marked for death. Did I check this one? Nope. Is this a... I don't want to step on no plate and have something go crashing down on my head. One of these things... Okay, is this the... No, I don't. Still don't see the lever. Always gotta try to be clever with this stuff. Does this lantern do anything? I mean, this is the door, but there should be a little chain or something that I need to pull. Maybe it is this, where was that stone? Standing on this? No. Nope. There's another door. Alright, maybe this is another way out. Any more doors? I think this is the only other one. Oh, no. Now I'm... Another door. How do I open this? Wow. Oh, here's a lever. Yeah, maybe I need to stop going around in first person mode. I wonder if there was a lever back another way. Anyhow, where are we now? Oh my goodness. Oh, are we back at the beginning? I don't remember all this ice and frost, though. Yeah, I think this is the way out. Or Okay, yeah, here we go. It's a fateful horse. Now would be a good time for that. There's a campsite mod that people use where they just set up a camp anywhere they want to. Could certainly use that. Wonder if I can sleep up here, maybe. What the heck? Oh, shit. Look at that. I think, yeah, that has to be the ability that the Redguard has. Let's see if I can figure out what this is. Well, this is one, Dust Storm. Disease resistance. Huh. Okay, no, I don't know what... But there's something causing these people, these things, to burst into flame. And it usually happens after I've killed one enemy, then the next one bursts into flame. Okay, and look here, we have a Sky Shard. If any of you have played Elder Scrolls Online, you know that was a way of leveling up the characters in that game, and somebody made a mod so that you could actually get perk points in this game. I'm going to activate it now. And I need three of these, just like in the Elder Scrolls Online, and then I'll get a perk point. Yeah, see, it would be nice if I had, like, a sleeping bag or something. I can just sleep here till daylight. Uh-oh. Got some trouble up ahead. Undead. Jesus. That's one thing, my powers don't have any resistance against the elements. Hold up. Oh, he's up there. Nope. You done with them bows and arrows. Or not. Alright. We got somebody up there still shooting. Look at this, extended invisibility. Hear something. Okay, now I didn't touch him and he burst into flame. What the hell is going on? Tall Papa, is that you? And he also trained with an alchemist in the weeks leading up to now, so that any ingredient that he eats, he automatically discovers all of the abilities that they have or what they can do. That's the way out. I think there's another door. Oh, there's a chest too. Robes of Minor Destruction. Well, we can always learn the enchantment. Like I interrupted somebody's dinner. Wait, a key. I bet it is. Well, I think this was already a. Uh-oh. I thought I could go through that door. Maybe I used the key or not. What the hell? Why is this stuff glowing like this? This might just be a It's like spider web. Pathetic is you attacking me. Yeah. Dead and naked. All that was empty. I should have resisted. So I think this is it for this dungeon. Well, maybe not. Look at these cells down here. Huh, that's not it. Oh, so that's what the key unlocked. Uh-oh. You usually don't unlock stuff for no reason, really? Oh, come on. There's nothing in here? Dog meat. Is that a shout out to Fallout 4 or Fallout 3 even? Wow. So that's it? There's nothing here to discover? Wow, that's bizarre. I guess we can get out of here. Uh-oh. So I came out somewhere different, and now I don't know where my horse is. They say wild companion, I don't think they're referring to the horse. Oh, here he is. Or she, I think it's a she. Okay. Continuing on toward Windhelm, and I guess we got yet another dungeon up here. And a mine. Uh-oh, stillborn cave. Uh-oh, we got ice wraiths down there too. Let me just go over here and discover the mine. Oh, really? I hope that's not a dragon. Uh-oh, who is this? Where's the mine? Here we go. Okay, whistling mine. And we got a barrow over here. That's what I think this symbol is. Journeyman's Nook. Wow, they just got so much stuff to explore. Where is my marker? Here we go. It's back this way. Alright, I'm going to have to open up the map and see how lost I truly am. Oh, we're headed... What city is this? Winterhold. And I was trying to go here to Windhelm? I guess, we're gonna change our destination. Oh, these damn wolves, really? Where'd that thing go? Oh, here it is. Yeah, you better run. Oh,
really? You should have run when you had the chance.
I remember when I first was trying out this game, before I installed the mods with the street lights and stuff, this place was so dark, it's like you couldn't see a damn thing. But look at it now. This is a, you know, warm, cozy.
Don't just walk away from me. Where do you think you're going?
To the inn for a drink.
drink, of course. Where else could I even go in this god's forsaken town?
And what? You think that'll solve all your problems?
Probably not, but it's worth a try.
Where's the inn? I need a room.
You ask me, not enough of Winterhold fell off into the sea. Nothing to do here but drink till you forget you got nothing to do.
Sorry, could you describe the smell?
Like some horrible monster was turned inside out and then exploded. What did you do?
Unless you're bringing me another round, you can just keep
I've already corrected it for future experiments.
This is why people have a problem with your college, Nelikar. Come on in. Just stoke the fire. Take a seat and get the cold out. If there's anything you need, just let me know.
I overheard something about a college.
That's right. College of Interhold, just north of town. Hard to miss.
What can you tell me about Winterhold?
I'm afraid there's not much to be said. Winterhold is hardly what it used to be. You can talk to Birna if you need to buy anything. He doesn't have much, but could certainly use the coin. And then there's our little inn. Most of the business we get is from folks here to visit the college. Though even that's dried up some.
I'm looking for work. Got any leads?
Here. Take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Okay, so a dragon I'm supposed to kill, that's a bounty? Alright. What have you got for sale?
Sate that appetite, huh?
Just gonna sell off all this stuff here. We accumulate it. That's actually a nice axe there. Alright, that has an enchantment. I need to learn that one. Alright, I guess that'll do. I'd like to rent a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
A door would be nice. I wouldn't mind some privacy, but I guess for 10 gold, I can't expect much more than this.
Well, all right, folks, we are going to end the video here.
Just read this real quick.
And we will continue with more adventures of Sundaar and probably try to tackle some of the more main stuff. But I'm just enjoying this game so much. I mean, just going around and exploring and going into these dungeons and whatnot, these caves. I am really enjoying this game, and I really don't understand why I didn't like it 5 years ago. But anyhow, thank you for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.